Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. Thank you for clicking on this video. If you are someone who enjoys talking about film, how about clicking that subscribe button? So today we're going to be talking about Bill and Ted's Bogus Journey. Of course, we do get Alex Winter back as Bill S. Preston Esquire and Keanu Reeves as Ted Theodore Logan. George Carlin, who plays Rufus, also returns for the sequel. We do get newcomer George Sadler, who plays the Reaper, who also appears in Face the Music. And then the futuristic villain of the story, which I'm gonna botch his real name and his fictional name as well. Just remember that it's just kind of who I am on mispronouncing people's names. So Joss Arklin as Delominos, we're gonna go with that. You can currently rent this particular movie on YouTube, on Prime Video for like $3, but honestly, you get at Walmart for $5, you can get both movies. So like I said in my Face the Music review, and I'm working my way backwards to you guys since I just started off with Face the Music. So that one, I do have it in second place within the trilogy. Bogus Journey does come out in third place. Now, not to say that it is a terrible movie, it's not, but it is, I believe, the weakest one out of the three. Oh, also, this is gonna be like a spoiler review. Let me go ahead and just say that as well. I didn't do a spoiler review for Face the Music, but I'm gonna do it for this one. Basically, in Bogus Journey, the futuristic villain, the Delominos, and that's just what we're gonna call him. Don't come after me if it's wrong. He's trying to kill Bill and Ted. So he took it upon himself to build some evil Bill and Ted robots and send them back into time to kill the real life Bill and Ted, take over and just ruin everything. They actually do succeed in capturing Bill and Ted and throwing them off a cliff. So yes, Bill and Ted die in Bogus Journey. Did go into, you know, death territory, which if you've seen the previews off of Face the Music, you do see the Grim Reaper there. And he was actually introduced in Bogus Journey. So of course he's there to collect the souls of Bill and Ted. Bill and Ted are, you know, not trying to go with them. They're trying to go and save the princesses from evil robot Bill and Ted. And they basically give the Reaper a wedgie and they escape and somehow end up in hell. And from hell, they kind of call the Reaper and they have to basically outwit him in the game, which apparently has never ever been done before. And of course, Bill and Ted outsmarted the Reaper and beat him in every game that they chose. So I'm assuming that the games that people never actually won were maybe more brain games, maybe like chess or something, and not like Battleship or Clue, Twister, because the Reaper, you know, sucked at those games. They were able to basically win their ticket back to Earth, where evil Bill and Ted have basically, you know, broken up, you know, the relationship with the princesses. You know what? I think before they actually made it back into their bodies, they took a little side trip to heaven. They talked to God and asked for his help on getting the most intelligent being to help build some robots, some good Bill and Ted robots to beat evil Bill and Ted robots. And that is where we meet the two little aliens called Station. I mean, at one point they kind of like merge into one big like alien deal. So they build some good Bill and Ted robots. Not obviously as good as evil Bill and Ted robots. They're very like robot looking robots, the good ones. But you know, it is short time and they happen to build these robots in the back of a van. They are mostly just in the afterlife in the Bogus Journey, and then of course just in present time and trying to like repair the damage that evil Bill and Ted have done. In Bogus Journey though, it is where Bill and Ted officially learn how to play the guitar. They get in the phone booth, they travel. I mean, obviously the way that time traveling works in these movies is kind of crazy, but it's very interesting. It's best not to try to put too much logic, because a lot of the things that happen is kind of like, okay, like really, how does this kind of work? But it's kind of almost like different universes as well. They go and they have like this 16-month guitar lesson deal. They come back and they're all like bearded up. They have kids. They got married. This is where we got introduced to Little Bill and Little Ted. Wasn't as entertaining or like epic or excellent as the first part. But of course, you know, if you do have a love and a soft spot for Bill and Ted, let me know down below, where do you guys rank this particular movie? Do you also find it to be the weakest of the bunch? But with that said, Bill and Ted's Bogus Journey is just gonna get a medium popcorn rating. If you are planning on watching these movies, definitely watch them in order. Otherwise, I feel like you will be lost. That's all my thoughts on Bill and Ted's Bogus Journey. If you've seen this movie, what did you guys think about it? Did you like it? Did you love it? Did you hate it? was it just not for you? And of course, before you guys click out of this video, don't forget to give it a like. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet. Don't forget to hit the notification bell so you'll be notified each time that I post something new. And until next time, I'll see you guys at concessions. Bye.